us and our parents, only you us and my nana's house. And the beauty that I saw in everything, the beauty in everything, yeah, was in her eyes.
With me, Mom, and Beverly. That's my sister. I didn't know I was poor. I didn't know there was a problem to be black, because there were no mirrors in my mama's house. No mirrors in my mama's house. There were no mirrors in my mama's house. No mirrors in my mama's house. And the beauty that I saw in everything, the beauty in everything, was in her eyes. I didn't know my skin was too black. I never knew my nose was too flat. I didn't know my clothes didn't fit. I never knew there were things that I missed. Cause the beauty in everything was in her eyes. Yeah. Yeah. The mirrors in my mama's. My mom was so beautiful, so pretty, and she had the kindest soul. She had nothing but love for Beverly and I, but none for herself. Mm-hmm. And you can count on getting the $25 in the card to support you and your endeavors. And that unconditional love was given out to friends, people she just meet, everyone but men. And every picture I took of my mama, I had my left arm behind her back, my right arm in front of her breast, and my leg wrapped around her, and I go, and no matter how old I got, I'd smash my face in her breast. Mommy, I squeezed her tight. Cheryl, stop that! Cheryl, stop that! Translation? Cheryl, I liked it. My daughter. I was encouraged to pursue my dreams. We all stood in line to get the government cheese. The noise in the hallway was music to me. The trash and the rubbish just cushioned my feet. And the beauty in everything was in her eyes. The only mirror we had in our house was in the bathroom, the medicine cabinet. I never really looked at myself in the mirror. Oh, just to check to see if I got toothpaste off my face. Then I was out. Because the biggest mirror in my house was looking into my mama's eyes.
Wow.
That was my approval. The world outside was a magical place. I only knew love and never knew hate. Because the beauty in everything was in her eyes.
I grew up in the Grant Projects. And then I became part of the stable. No, not the prostitute cat. Well, maybe sort of. But maybe I get fries. But maybe I get Saturdays, but never I get the whole weekend. And the holidays, they were up for grabs. But I didn't see you last Thanksgiving. What's wrong with what? But it don't matter, because I always had me a man. Until I came to California. But I know this is it. You know, I get so frustrated because it's not happening fast enough. It's happening in real time. Shit! I've dated tall men, short men, fat men, skinny men, bald men, men with locks, mamas with boys, controlling men. I just want a man who has a job.
Yeah.
Apartment.
Yeah.
Ready to embark on nice sized dick. You know, not one of them long, excessively long ones that they curve off to the side.